Years ago, I was an addict. I was strung out. I didn't care. I was a criminal facing prison time, not being able to see above water. You hit rock bottom, and you just hope to make it back to start your life over. I was 17 when I first joined the military in high school, in between my junior and senior year. You know, I wanted the training and the discipline and the respect that was gained for being in the military. A window came open for a unit out of Fort Stewart, Georgia that was deploying to Iraq, and I jumped on board, and then I eventually deployed to Iraq. I had planned on it to be my career, so I wanted to do 20 years in the military, but I ended up getting injured, and that cut it short. I was playing basketball and actually tore my ACL. I had surgery on it, it was repaired. I re-tore it just doing training in the military. I was given about a 300-pill prescription to deploy to Iraq with because they knew I would have pain in the knee since it was re-torn. It was injured the entire time I was in Iraq, jumping in and out of vehicles, running from building to building. I felt like I was a super soldier. I could, you know, do anything whenever I was on those pain pills. I didn't care, you know, if it was being shot at or something was blowed up because I was really out of my mind. I mean, I did not care at that time, right? It didn't raise a red flag in my mind because at that time, I really didn't know what addiction was and it wasn't a big deal in society. So I never really thought about it. So I had seen a battalion doc and then ended up getting referred to a division surgeon who put me on a 25 microgram fentanyl patch, which is designed for deathly ill cancer patients. But he felt like that I wasn't really addicted and wasn't sick, but that I needed narcotics on around the clock. So he decided I could not deploy anymore because of that, and I was stuck back in the States and ended up getting medically discharged out of the military. It was devastating to me when I found out I couldn't serve anymore. It broke my heart. I made sergeant before I turned 21. It was a promising career, and I was proud. It was something that my family looked up to, my little brother looked up to. So when I got out, it just kind of all went downhill from there. I had no plan because the military was my plan. Not only had I had a knee injury twice, I had a pain pill addiction that I was dealing with as well. I felt like I could control it, even though I couldn't control it. I just was more focused on not being sick and without that medication. It breaks you down. It literally physically breaks you down. I mean, it makes you feel like you're 80 years old when you're 20. You feel sick, cold sweats, body aches, irritability, can't sleep. I was more worried about getting pills and chasing them around town and staying up all night than I was holding down a job or taking care of my family. My marriage took a turn for the worse, and we ended up separating at that time. I went through a 30-day program. Part of your program is to apply for a job whenever you get out. And that's when I applied for the VA Medical Center in Memphis and was hired on in the mailroom as a mail clerk. My job as a mail clerk was to go up to the second floor outpatient pharmacy and bring down the controlled substance narcotics down to the mail room and ship those out to different areas. I don't know what they was thinking, honestly. To put somebody to do that type of work is like putting an alcoholic and making them a bartender. It went okay at first, but again, my addiction took off. So I would actually go down each day and break into the packs and take out the narcotics out of the pill bottles. I would never take all of them. I would just take part of them so it wasn't noticeable. It went on for about a year, and then I was hit with a sting operation that the VA was doing. They actually baited a pack with invisible ink. And whenever I opened the pack that day, I did notice an aerosol smell come out of the pack that day. But I guess my drive to get that pill didn't really care. So I went ahead and got them, put them in my pocket, and in front of me comes a special agent, and behind me comes a special agent. They handcuffed me in the hallway in the VA. Very embarrassing because I'm a service-connected veteran myself. You know, I took these pills from other veterans. These pills could have went to people with cancer or people that were dying or things like that. And those are my fellow brothers and sisters in arms, you know, and I would do anything for them. So for me to do that, you know, that was horrible and something that I had to live with for the rest of my life. I became homeless, and I mean, I had nowhere to live. The same people that I seen looking for food in trash cans as I was walking to the VA every day in my suit and tie, that was me. You know, I became that person. The turning point for me was whenever I did not have a place for my daughter and my son to go to, not having a stable environment and not being that person that my children could look up to. So I had to try something different. My family, you know, is my everything. To have them look up to me and have them respect me for what I do, for the man I am now, means so much to me. You know, my father wasn't in my life as much as I felt like I wanted him to be. So I always felt like I was going to be that best father for my children, right? So I found a methadone clinic in town that had good counselors, a good support system. That was my first day, February 1st, 2011. I consider that my sober day. So being convicted, nobody wants to hire you. If you tell the employer that you've had the charge, most of the time it's an automatic disqualifier. But if you hide it from them and they find it, then you get disqualified from that. I was disqualified from several jobs, and they will let you know what came back on your background. Because of that, I knew it was gonna be really tough to get a job. You know, you wanna give up, you wanna quit, but at that time, I had too much to live for, and I was not gonna quit. I started going to the business college in town for medical assisting, and actually graduated top of my class, got Medical Assistant of the Year award, saw a video for veterans for Kelly Services and how they help veterans when they return. And I felt like, you know, that may be where I want to go. Position I took, it was temporary and part-time, and I worked on the assignment for about 4 to 6 weeks whenever I was hired on full-time with Kelly. I worked for Kelly as a talent advisor on site for one of the largest global packaged food companies. A little over 300 people is what I take care of. I actually work with talent from day one, from their first day on site until their end of assignment. I'm back into a leadership position. I'm back where I wanted to be. Everybody has a past. Everybody's had something happen in their life that they're not proud of. Things in their life that, you know, they'd rather not tell someone about. These people are people that just want that chance to do better with their lives, and they will be the most dedicated employees you have. And if you give them a chance, I promise you, you won't regret it. I'm not like that anymore. I'm not that guy. And now here today, I'm someone that my kids can look up to and maybe want to be one day. Everybody wins.